So I'm here with Uncle Vance at the SBTV Summer Cookout.
What am I saying? Well, since I came here, I've not enjoyed anything besides Tekken, and I feel that's my own fault because I got sucked in. They can't put games that I enjoy.
Did you win?
Many times, and I also lost many times. Just gonna say that
did
now.
You win more than you lost?
Yeah.
Yeah, half Nigerian, half Equatorial Guinea.
So jollof rice.
Yeah, Nigerian jollof rice is the best. Long grain rice. Like anyone that makes jollof rice with anything other than long grain rice is a fraud.
So and Nigerian they need to call me to represent them.
Well, it's not even a comparison. So by you even saying Nigerian over Ghanaian is an insult to Nigerians. Nigerians are on a different platform. There's no comparison.
But do you know where jollof rice actually originates from?
Listen, everyone says that, but jollof is a Nigerian word. So
what does it mean?
Special rice.
So, have you had jollof rice before?
Of course.
So, are we talking more Nigerian or Ghanaian? Which one are you feeling?
You see, this is where I had so much questions about this. I think the best one is Nigerian.
Really?
Yeah, Nigerian jollof rice. Any ola? Nigerian jollof rice all day. Nigerian jollof rice all day.
Are you saying it because it's your friend and he's just...
No, I prefer it. Taste-wise and the way the rice is better.
I'm from Gambia.
Alright, so I'm gonna ask you a question.
Yeah. Yeah.
I wanna know, like, which rice is better, Nigerian or Ghanaian?
I'll tell you something. There's a fact that's missing. Like, if they're both beefing.
Yeah. Oh, fact check.
They're both beefing about the jollof rice originally from Gambia. Google it. Probably come up in Senegal, but Senegal and Gambia were the same country once upon a time.
Now you see, I had someone contradict that fact today. Someone said that the word jollof originated from Nigeria.
That's fine, but in our language, we don't call it jollof. Like, universally, people call it jollof because I don't know why. Because they claimed it by accident, but it really is. But in my language, it's called something different, innit? And that's what we know it as.
So you're trying to say that, you know, Gambia,
they stole it, and it's better. You're following the crowd,
I'd rather break the rules and you're copying. Today's a cookout.
Okay.
So I don't know if you know, I know you're not from like Africa or the Caribbean, but you know about this whole beef about plantain.
Of course.
So I just want to know, like, what do you call it? Plantain or plantain?
I call it plantain.
Perfect, thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
You know what it is, right? I don't know. It's a case where, like, you know, Africans, you know, we're all African.
Yeah.
And you know, I think that, you know, that people have kind of lost their sense of identity, you know.
Why'd you say that?
Because they don't have to pronounce plantain. Come back to Africa.
Is that gunshots for the Caribbeans then?
I wouldn't say gunshots because I'm a lawyer, but I say it's a subtle dig.
Subtle dig. You see, when someone's in the legal sector, they have to
be very careful.
Sure.
You're televising this, right? So I've got to be careful about what I say online.
Oh, okay. Don't worry. I'll bleep anything that sounds a bit incriminating.
All right, then. I'll let it go now.
Like what you told me before the conversation started.
I didn't tell you.
You know, you're the first African that said that.
Plantain don't sound succulent. Plantain does. Sounds...
Yeah, so plantain.
Yeah, 100%. 100%.
Yeah.
Who would you want to collaborate with?
Oh.
In the UK. And what?
Jay Huss.
Really?
Yes. Yeah. Jay Huss is just one of a unique kind of artist. Like, you would not find him anywhere else. Like, I say give him any type of rhythm and he would just smash it. And you know it's like expected to be a big hit.
Yeah. So what would you be doing? Singing or rapping?
No, rapping, definitely. Rapping, but I'll get Huss to do the hook. And the cheeky ad-libs.
You're an artist yourself.
Yeah.
If you could collaborate with any artist in the UK, you bring out their living, okay?
100% Angel. Like, I proper love Angel.
If you were an artist,
yeah,
and you could collaborate with any UK artist, who would it be and why?
UK artist? Jay Huss.
You're the second person to say that.
Yeah, the reason why is that at this moment in time, he has an authentic sound.
Yeah.
everybody else sounds like someone else, or they're trying to incorporate a sound. He has his own unique Afro beats, grime, fusion sound that's just so unique. Like, I listened to the album and I was just like, wow, he's got a very unique sound.
Yeah.
Even his slang is just, for me, he's the person.
So talking about the album, what are your top songs on the album?
Good Luck Charlie, Friendly, and Boof Daddy.
Trying
to test me to see whether I know the album.
I know, should I have to ask
you? Did you see his commercial?
Yeah.
Like, it's a good song, but just in terms of like my preference.
Yeah.
Like, you can tell that, like, in terms of production, flow, lyrics, those three songs I chose, good. And it shows how diverse he is.
Yeah.
Party tracks, you know, something a bit more slow, mellow.
Sugar. Yeah. We're here at the SBTV Summer Cookout.
Yeah.
And to be honest, I feel like the lineup is missing you.
Really?
Oh.
I could take the stage, but do you know what? Like, these things, they take time, innit? I'm cooking. When it's my time, I'll get on that stage.
So are you keeping up to date with like the artists that are coming up in the scene these days?
You got Young Bane.
Yeah.
Probably the only person that I'm really paying attention to at the moment.
So you think he's someone that everyone else should pay attention to as well?
I think they're going to it at one point or another. Like, I think that he's the person that's the next to blow.
So name two more artists as well in that category.
What, in terms of collaborating with?
Up Next to blow, or people that deserve recognition.
People that deserve recognition, Most Stack.
Yeah.
Again, I think he's really good. Mist. Who else is there? Notes. Only because Notes has got like the formula for commercial success. Like, he's just been able to make a number of tracks that are commercially successful. So him, in terms of like a strict artist point of view, maybe not, but just in terms of someone being musically successful, then I'd say him.
Yeah, I mean, last year was incredible. Last year, like, there was a lot of highlights from last year, especially like Lancey and House of Pharaohs, who are back on the lineup again. So they're the ones to watch out for this year. And yeah, man. Okay, so in terms of performance, and who I say to watch out for, H.O.P., Lancey's number two, obviously Novelist.
Yeah.
Jack That will have a crazy grime set as well. Reason why I say House of Pharaohs are the ones to watch out for especially is because their energy is just immense. Like, they remind me of a UK version of A$AP Mob.
Oh, wow.
Like, crazy.
That's big.
Also, Daniel OG is another one because he opened for Lil Uzi and Yachty in the last year. So he's another one to watch out for. So watch out for Daniel OG as well.
Baby, when I say it's your time, you say you make a whole tight. Now she says she won't give me that. She give me African waist like T.Y. She won't give me that.